Alright, let me close this player here, internet player. Let's go to the code. Okay. We have to create our stack. Here my stack is my stack. It has an integer that is the top of the stack each time. And the two-dimensional array, this is where we store our strings. It has five positions for the rows, a 30 position for the columns. Now remember, this can be changed, and this can be changed also in order for us to store different sizes, different strings, and different size of strings inside our stack. As long as the RAM is not overflown. Now, how to create a stack? You have to declare first a variable, global variable, a stack named, let's call it SS. And after that, you say that the top of the stack will be -1. So in this way, we create a stack. Now we have to check if the stack is empty by returning a condition here, an answer true or false, whether the top of the stack is -1 or not. Now how we insert we use four functions here, and one to create our stack, the second to check if the stack is empty, and the other two is for the insert and the get and the set functions, in and out functions. Now how to store an element, a char array string to our stack? We have to increase first the top of the stack. Okay, and after that we copy inside the array of the strings in the proper position of the rows, in the proper row, and all the columns we copy the string that we send to this function in our typical parameter. Okay. And of course, if the stack is full, we say no action, stack is full. So how to get a stack out of the an element, a string out of our stack? If the stack is empty, we print a message and nothing is happens. But if the stack is not empty, we say that we copy from the top of our stack, the string that is being contained at the top of our stack inside the typical parameter here, inside the char array name. So in our main, what I do is I create the stack first. Be careful, this is very important. In order to work your program, you have to create first a stack. So remember the create function, just initialize the top counter, okay? And after that, I say how many names, and I read an integer from the standard input. I have showed you in the past how to create your own scanf. But this time, in order to take numbers and not strings from the input, but this time, let's say that this number will be correct. So the user will not try to fake you and to trick you, and he will give a correct number. So if the number, see, it has a weakness, and this is one of its weakness, that if here the user tries to write and a string and you want to scan for an integer, this will terminate the program, will exit the program. This will make an error, will create an error at your compiler and an executable file. So it will stop the program. But let's say that this time we'll hit the number. I say give the name. I scan from the input again for a string this time. You see here I scan F percentage S. Okay. And I put it inside our stack. With this function I explained you how it works before. This function here in. And after that I say what element do you want from the from this item, from these names, what in the sequence of the names, what element do you want to print on the screen, and I use a char pointer here, help, in order to store the name from the stack, from our stack, from the two-dimensional array inside our stack, okay. And this time I have a loop from any is the dimension of the stack, is the number of the stop, is a number of the counter that has reached this number here, minus one, of course, because it starts from zero, minus the element we want from our stacks. And after that, I print, you have selected this name, and I print it on the screen. Let's run to see. Now I will give five names. Okay. I will give five names. Let's give this name here. Let's give this name. Let's give this name also. Let's give this name. And then let's give this name. And let's try to get the first name. So I'll give here one. And you see here you have selected this name. Okay. The first name. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much. Don't forget to subscribe for more. Like, comment, and share this video. Okay, thank you very much. Bye.